spice and all things nice. That's what little girls are made of. Remember the old nursery rhyme? Add dedication and talent, and it's an apt description of a gamin little girl who's writing figure skating history. But mere words don't do her justice. You have to see her in action. Tracy Wainman. Last January in Halifax, she made skating history. She became the youngest skater to capture the Senior Women's Canadian Figure Skating Championship. Tracy is 13 years old. What was your feeling, Trace, when you won the Canadian Ladies Championship?
I was excited. It happened a lot fast, because like 2 years before I was winning novice. You know, and then the next 2 years I'm winning Senior Canadians. It happened really fast.
Last year, when she was only 12, she had a crack at the World Championships. She placed 14th in the overall standings, but was 10th in the free skating. Next weekend, she will try again at this year's World Contest in Hartford, Connecticut. She hopes to place in the first 10. If she does, she may be on her way to joining some illustrious names. Canada had three world champion women skaters, Barbara Ann Scott, Petra Burka, and Karen Magnuson. Scott won the world crown in 1947 and 1948, besides winning the Olympic gold medal in 1948. Barbara Ann Scott's return was triumphant. But in the last few years, the fortunes of Canada's female single skaters have been sliding steadily in the international arena. Then in the last few years, this little girl came along. Tracy Wainman began to skate at the age of 5 and a half. Her natural talent became soon evident. She started to win competitions. There are no shortcuts. For 6 days a week, in the early morning, Mrs. Wainman begins her long day of chauffeuring and chaperoning by driving her daughter to the Toronto Cricket and Curling Club, where Tracy starts her working day with the first skate at 5 minutes to 7. When a big competition like the World Championship lies ahead, Tracy skates at least 4 to 5 hours a day.
Just check the lineup here.
Ellen Burka is Tracy's coach. Burka's first champion was her own daughter, Petra, who won the World Championship in 1965.
A match, match, match.
Figure skating is a strict science. And in championship skating, precision is like gold. Ellen Burka exacts top effort from her young pupil. The results are satisfying.
I still think it's sloppy. You can do better even with the light. Careful.
She can be pretty tough, can't she?
Uh-huh.
But that's what you want in a coach, isn't it?
Yes. That's what I need, at least. Somebody to push me so I can get going.
And someone who won't take any guff from you.
Yeah.
To become a figure skating champion, you must have the body of an athlete combined with personality, determination, patience, self-control, and a bright mind.
I first saw her come on the ice when she was about 9 years old or so. I really looked at that little girl and said, my goodness, that girl really has potential, because she moved so fast, she could jump high. She had a lot of spirit in her, and I said, watch that girl.
In this two-year-old film, Tracy shows the promise that made her Canadian champion in 1981. But the child's sense of play is not lost.
Well, I just really like it a lot, and it's fun. That's why I do it.
Is it possible, Ellen, to push a child too hard too soon in figure skating?
Yes, absolutely. I don't believe in that either. A lot of people sometimes say, well, Tracy can't do 5 triple jumps yet and these things. I said, I don't want her to do that because I think it should come naturally. If you can do it, it will happen, and if you can't do it, it will not happen.
A lot of times, I think, mothers who are pushing and the child doesn't want to do it, it doesn't work.
Tracy's mother, Gay Wainman.
No amount of pushing is going to make them go out on their figures and concentrate. They have to want it themselves. And I think the parents have to be there, and I don't call it, I call it gentle motivation.
Well, I became gently motivated to put on my skates.
I'm all shaky. Do you get shaky at all, ever? I haven't skated for so long, I've forgotten how.
Well, I don't take that much off, though.
Yeah. If you do take time off, what happens?
It feels weird when I skate, you know? And my jumps, I have to get used to it. But then after like a day or something, I'm used to it.
It comes right back?
Yeah.
But you think it'll ever come back for me?
If you work at it, it will.
But training on the ice is not the only athletic activity. The home must become a training ground as well. Daily exercises are essential if you want to stay in top shape. And Tracy is a superb athlete. So every day, as regular as clockwork, Tracy does the rope, and even the stairs can be used. Tracy's schooling is a strictly regulated affair. The hours are adjusted so as to fit in with her skating practice. Options are eliminated, and time at home is used to work ahead. Tracy gets good marks in school and does especially well in math. She knows how to set her priorities.
A lot of people just think that I just skate, you know, and I don't even bother with school. But school is like the most important, and I have to keep up my schoolwork while I'm skating, and I think it helps my skating also.
You're a perfectionist, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Does it help to be good at math?
I think that my skating helps me in my math because I'm taught how to concentrate and to figure things out. So when I do go to my math, then I can pick up something, you know, quickly.
You can conceptualize it, you can sort of see it
uh-huh.
in your mind's eye.
Yeah.
How well did you do in your last math test?
Well, my last two I got perfect.
When Gay Wainman and Tracy return home from skating practice and school, the working day is not over yet. While Gay prepares dinner, Tracy finds a quiet spot to do a bit more homework before dinner is ready. Sacrifices are made by the whole family.
You work this thing down,
Tracy receives some subsidies from the Canadian government and the Canadian Figure Skating Association, but her father, Dwight Wainman, a chartered accountant, pays about $25,000 annually for his daughter's skating career. Travel costs, $500 skates, fees for the coach, membership fees at the club, and ice time. And then there's Corey, Tracy's 10-year-old brother, who often is left behind when Tracy and her mother travel to a competition. At a family dinner, when everybody is around him, he takes the stage.
How was school today, Corey?
Good, but I had lots of bad luck.
What happened?
Bow! I spelled B-O-W. It's B-O-U-G-H. And the White Cliffs of, I can't remember this.
Dover.
How'd you know?
But it always comes back to the one thing, skating.
Sometimes in the air, you know if you're going to fall, like in the air. But it happens so quickly, you don't have time to correct it. So you have to be thinking before you go in exactly how. You're up in the air in a jump, like for such a short time. You have to think about it a lot, you know, before, because if you do it wild, then it won't happen. I think spins are the hardest out of jumps I can just sort of do, and the spins it takes a lot more time, and I don't like practicing either.
Which are the more difficult among the spins?
I find the most is camel spin is the most difficult for me.
Well, how do you know how to get the perfect alignment?
Mrs. Burka tells me, you know, exactly where it should be, and so I have to go out there and try.
If your leg isn't just quite high enough, she'll yell at you, raise your leg.
Yeah, and then so I have to raise my leg, and then so that's how, you know, it comes to get good.
What do you have to prepare yourself for when you go into a layback?
Well, you have to just get your body straight. You have to make sure you don't lose your balance. And then you have to bend back, you know, at the right time, or else, you know, you go flying. But that's one of my favorite spins.
So when Tracy goes to the World Championships next week, she has not only the support of her family, but also the best wishes of the whole nation behind her. Good luck, Tracy.
If you want to watch Tracy at the World Skating Championship at Hartford, Connecticut, it will be carried live on CTV next Saturday afternoon from 4:30 to 6 Eastern Standard Time.